Yes, now let's talk about the fruits of the Spirit. Praise God. See, chong into ba haphazela njani lendi my relationship, which is marriage. Glory to God. That's what we're going to be talking about today. Praise God forever. Especially in jema kule lockdown. Glory to God. Into hlala kunye isidala ni usoloko ni sendlini eyi-1 idinga a fruits of the Spirit. Praise God. Idinga a character yakho. Because it's a little bit of a time, but I don't know what I'm saying. I don't know what I'm saying. I'm saying nobody over time I'm saying because if you avoid the confrontation, you're saying, praise God. And so these are the keys that you need to know and to have. Glory to God in your relationship. And apply, praise God, forevermore, so that it enhance a relationship. And we're going to be looking at the book of Galatians, the 5th chapter, talking about the fruits of the Spirit. Verse 16, I say, therefore, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusts against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary to one another, so that you not do the things that you wanted to do. Now, the works of the flesh are evident, which are adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lewdness, idolatry, sorcery, hatred, contentions, jealousies, outbursts of wrath, selfish ambition, dissensions, heresies, envy, murder, drunkenness, revelries, and the like, of which I told you before, just as I also told you in times past, that those who do these things or practice such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things there is no law. Glory to God. Against such things there is no law. Now, the first thing that we need to establish, classes Mamelinda, we need to establish that the New Testament was written in Greek. And there's something about the Greek writing. You'll find, but there were no capital letters with Greek writing. There are no punctuations with Greek letters. So a punctuation and also a capital letters were put there at the pleasure of the translators who wanted to make meaning of the scriptures. Glory to God. And one of the things they did, is El Gamalti Spirit, while making in capital letter Spirit, meaning that the Spirit of God or the Holy Spirit, glory to God. But the upper, the Spirit that Paul is talking about is your own reborn Spirit. The fruit of your Spirit, your reborn Spirit. You understand? We amplified the fruit of your Spirit by the Holy Spirit. Glory to God. Praise God forevermore. Because umoya oyingcwele akanasiqhamo esiluthando. Umoya oyingcwele luthando. Glory to God forevermore. Uzizo zonke zizinto, but he has come to help your Spirit produce these things. Praise God. So, in the fruit of the Spirit, verse 22, is love, joy, and peace. Now, Jesus, you know, we might take the other ones, but it's love. Praise God. Love has been put in you for you. Romans chapter 5 verse 5, the love of God has been shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Spirit whom we have received. Glory to God. So we have love. So uthando luka Thixo siluthululelwe ezinhlizweni zethu ngomoya oyingcwele samnikayo. Why? Uthando lukhona for wena so that you know, praise God forevermore. What I mean is that long experiencing love, it is not the fault of the people. Glory to God, because you are not supposed to derive love from men. You're supposed to derive love from God. It's wonderful. That's wonderful. It's great. But funeka uxhomekeke kuThixo ngo experience uthando. Around wena. You always experience love because uthando ulifumana kuthi isource yakho yothando uThixo. And uThixo ulapha kuwe ngaphakathi ngomoya oyingcwele. Praise God. That love is there in you, for you. Glory to God. The same, the other thing is joy. Ijoy yakho ayixhomekekanga ebantwini ohlala nabo. Glory to God. Ayixhomekekanga kwindlela abakuphethe ngayo okanye indlela abangakuphathanga ngayo. But ijoy yakho comes from God. And there is a difference between joy and happiness. Happiness is governed by physical comfort. Xa izinto zikuhamba kakuhle nabantu bekuphethe kakuhle, you can truly say that you are happy, but joy does not take into consideration the present circumstances of his enemies. Think about Paulus and Silas. Paulus and Silas, they did something good for uThixo. They cast out a devil out of a person. Babanjwa, babethwa, bagxiza igazi emqolo. Emveni koko bathathwa bayofakwa kwesona simnyama isele, kwafakwa namakhuna babe kunamhlanje bebezawufakwa la bhola yensimbi. Priority prisoners. Glory to God. But end down your colors, because they have every reason. Wabanga colors, but teachers and Latino patronizing criminals. Mr. Sends in the Zinch, Mr. Shumaela, Sistine sends as long as those put to play. You know, but end down your colors, the Bible, they prayed and sang praises to God. My servants joy, my vuya. Imeko ingacho. The circumstances around them did not were not conducive for baba ngavuya, but bavuya ithi Bible abamanye amabhantindi ayebeva behlabelele. And iBhayibhile, the place where they were at was physically shaken. There was an earthquake. Kwafuneka neengcango zentolongo, kwawa namatshayina emabhantindini. Praise God, because joy is not derived from your present circumstances. No, circumstances, Lord, you can have joy because joy is in you. I come in ganga win lela aband of a petting eye. I come in ganga with circumstances is offensive in us physically. You can have joy no by imek or eating na because your joy is supposed to be derived from God. And in the Bible, I tell that in His presence there is fullness of joy. Glory to God. And so you have to use this opportunity. Yoba utandaz, glory to God, may we presence, ufuna ubusuku Thixo, glory to God, so that you may experience joy. Glory to God, no bime kuthini, noba ihamba ngolupi uhlobo, endlini yakho, you have joy. Praise God. The other fruit of the Spirit is peace. You know, it uthi uYesu, peace I give unto you. My peace, you know, I don't give you as the world gives. He was saying differentiate from peace yehlabathi. Peace yehlabathi, absence of violence, absence of turmoil and chaos. But peace is the Greek word eirin. You know, from the Hebrew word shalom, praise God, which means wholeness, nothing missing, nothing broken, spirit, soul, and body, praise God. And all at all, you can be at peace. No be mekos lol pinushob. No ba imekos yenyuka. No be mekos yesha. You are at peace. You have to draw from within. Glory to God. And to draw from within, the Bible, I tell you, with joy, we shall draw water out of the wells of salvation. Ngovuyo sikha amanzi kumaqula osindiso. Sikha amanzi kuqula losindiso. Ngovuyo. Glory to God. Praise God forevermore. And you know the word Jesus means salvation. Jesus, liminisha salvation. So to draw from Him, you're drawing from Him through joy. Once uvuye uyakha kwelaqula losindiso. You are drawing strength because the Bible, the joy of the Lord is our strength. Glory to God. Uyakha kwelaqula losindiso ngovuyo. Glory to God. Imeko ingavumi usukuhlabelela ingoma. Kube mnandi ndandobulandela ndoba utata ekhaya wenza u A B C D E, umama ekhaya wenza u A B C D E, abantwana benza u A B C D E. Ufocus kakhulu kwintoba ndilapha kulendlu bendijamelele nomfazi napha kulendlu bendijamelele nalendoda utya kakhulu kwenzeka ngolu hlobo nolu hlobo nolu hlobo zonke ezo zikhalazo kuba draw from within, because salvation is on the inside of you, because Jesus is on the inside. The word Jesus, Yeshua, means salvation. Glory to God. And to draw from him, you draw through joy. That's why I say to Paulus, rejoice in the Lord. And I say again, rejoice. Glory to God. Would I rejoice in the Lord, not in the way things look and seem and sound. Glory to God. But you rejoice in the Lord. There's always joy in the Lord. Praise God. Amen. I'll rejoice in the way things look like. You know, you don't rejoice in the way things seem. Praise God. But you rejoice in the Lord. And again, I say, rejoice. Glory to God. Praise God forevermore. In the Bible, hlalani nivuya. Thandazani ningayiki. Ezintweni zonke bulelani. Praise God. Hlalani nivuya. Is it possible? He would never have commanded us to do that if it was impossible. Praise God. And in the Bible, a man shall have joy by the answer of his mouth. Proverbs chapter 15, verse 23. A man shall have joy by the answer of his mouth. That is why you have to have the knowledge of the promises of God. About every circumstance of his life. Because the Bible, God has given us exceeding great and precious promises, so that by these promises you might be partakers of the divine nature. God, praise God forevermore. He has given us his promises. And through those promises, you can answer every circumstance of facing. And if you know how to answer every circumstance of facing, then you'll have joy. Because in the Bible, a man have joy by the answer of his mouth. And when you spend time in the Word of God, you spend time praying in the presence of God, you receive the exceeding great and precious promises. The Spirit of God will lead you to the promises that cover your situation. And he will tell you what to speak in that circumstance. And if you can answer that circumstance, then you will have joy, because the Bible mentions have joy by the answer of his mouth. Praise God.